the Sphero one first. Right, okay. What is Sphero? Well, it's a robotic ball. I'm going to give you a demonstration of it now in a minute. It's basically a robotic ball which connects via Bluetooth. It's completely waterproof, and it's made out of polycarbonate, which means you could basically chuck it against a brick wall very hard, and it won't break. It can travel up to 7 feet per second, and it is pretty quick. This is the second version of it, but they've actually got a new one after this, but it's a more of a two-wheel device, and it's got three gyroscopes and three accelerometers, which means you can get feedback from it from the different sensors, such as collision detection, how far it's travelled, and a number of LEDs in there, which you can actually change. So I'm going to quickly go into a quick demonstration of this ball. So what you'll see here now is, right, this is Sphero. It's a little ball. It's about the size of a tennis ball or a baseball. And to switch it on, you just tap it twice and it comes on. And you can see it's flashing, so it's not actually connected. So what I'm going to do is connect to Sphero and just give you a quick demonstration. And it's conductive charging as well. So it actually sits on this pad and it charges up. So it connects via Bluetooth. So I'm just going to make sure my Bluetooth's on. And it should. There we are. Right. And I'm going to start an app that I created to in my version of App Inventor. So what you can see, this is the phone here, and over on right here is the app, so you can actually see it a bit better. Got it linked live. So once it's connected, it'll go straight into the app, and the first thing you do, there's a little tail light on the back, which you can see, it's a little blue light, and you need to get that in line with the arrow on here. Okay, once you've done that, you've now got control. And you'll see this arrow, which you can also see on the screen over here, is actually rotating as I'm moving it, and the sensors below are actually changing as well. So it's showing you the heading it's moving, plus the tilt as it's moving as well. So if I turn it this way, also on the right hand side, you can see the speed it travels, which is useful if you want to, well, it's useful for games and things. You can change the colour and different things, and also the distance, and they're all in centimetres. I'm not sure what the speed is at the moment, but there we are. So if I go into the control screen, I've created, okay, another thing you can actually change the colours on here. So just by colors, and you can make it do different tricks. So I can make it rotate. I've turned the colors off so you can actually see it moving around, because it's not very you can make it jump, do different tricks, spin, vibrate, I don't know, yeah, you can probably see it vibrating and running around as I'm changing things. So that's basically the things I've added to this component. What I'm going to do is just go behind the scenes of that now, and how you'd actually do this in App Inventor. So let me just come back out of this app now. Right, I'll just get the... Bear with me 2 seconds. This is a much more cut down version of the app. You can see here, it's just going to show you how it all goes together. Right, so I can actually start the app, but it works a lot quicker. So what's happening there is, as soon as you start the app up, it tries to connect to Sphero, the nearest Sphero. As soon as it's connected, oh, sorry, I need to have the two screens open. I'm just trying to do it so you can see what I'm doing at the same time. There we are. Oh, damn it. There we are. Right, so this is the app here. If I reconnect, you can see now Sphero is trying to connect, and once it's found Sphero, it will change color and flash, and it says it's found Sphero, and it jumps into the app then. The code for that is, so basically what I'm doing, can you see the, is that clear enough on the screen? Yeah, I can see Robert nodding his head. Right, so all I'm doing here, I've got a timer set up. So it's an invisible component, first of all, sorry, which is, because I'm still doing experiments on it, I've actually going to put in my internal, which is here, and I just drag that onto the screen, it becomes a invisible component. And what you were seeing then, when I was connecting to it, it's just I've got a status, and all it's doing is checking whether Sphero is connected. When it does, it switches on the panel. So it's looking for Sphero's name, which in this case is Sphero BGB, which is the colors. Every Sphero has its own unique colors. Mine goes blue, green, blue when it's not on. So once you've done that, you can do a lot of different things in here. So if I show you, what was it? I can actually rotate. This was what was happening in the other app. You can see as I'm turning Sphero, you can see the arrow on the screen is moving. And how I'm doing that, I've actually got this is the block for it. So I've gone and put a movement sensor component here, and all it's doing, I'm changing the heading in line with what Sphero. So that's all the code is there for doing that. Now, if I want to do, say I wanted to get Sphero to, what have I done here? Turn the tail light on and off. Okay, there we are. I'm turning Sphero's lights off totally. So I'm just going to press, this button here. And when I press it, you can see as I'm touching the button down, it's turning it. When I take it down, it's turning the light on, and when I'm touching it up, it's turning the light off. What I've done here, rather than putting all the commands as a call, I've actually done as a link function. So you actually put your command, which is a common thing for all of them, and then you put what you want to do to it. If I want to do more than one command, I'm using a list function. So what I've done here now, so I'm gonna call this one now, and what it's going to do, let me see, I can't remember. It's going to change color, and it's going to jump 30 times. Let me just see what that does. So I've got the command here. You can see on this, if I can bring it down. I've got the command here, and it's calling what's in the list, all the commands in the list. So if I do that, whoops, it's jumping off the table. There is another command I've put in there as well, which is to stop any other command that's happening. And you can see as I'm putting my finger, if I move this over on the thing, it starts doing the command. And when I take my finger off, it stops jumping around. And that is just this command stop. And that's basically all there is to controlling. There is also collision detection, which I haven't put into this app. But that's basically all this component is. I can give you another demonstration of something which is, I've linked this to the next component. It's basically a...
commands you can pass is like a string that you're actually passing, or...?
Yeah. I'm basically... What I've got here, in here, each one of these commands, I put in a code for it. So I've put it into a string, so it actually passes that information into this function here. So when it does, it actually runs the macro, which is for the jump statement. And all I'm doing in here is a for loop statement. So it does the one command and then puts another one in. So I can go on to the next bit. It's only a small thing. It just demonstrate me using it with a sound meter, which is the same sort of thing. You went and put a sound meter in a while back, Hussein, didn't you? I think in your a sound sensor, in your a sound component. I think both me and you went and put one in a long, long time ago. We went and put an amplitude.
Right. That's right.
Yeah. Well, what I've done, I've created a... Let me come back out to this app. Right. So as soon as you come out of the app, you can see Sphero starts flashing again. So if I... Oh, which one is it? Sphero goes crazy. There we are. Nice, simple app. And what this app is, it's just a sound sensitive... Just a minute, I've got this... So what this one does, I'm just seeing now, hang on, should be picking up my voice. There we are. So you can see it's actually changing colour as I'm speaking because I put the sound meter on it. It's just showing how you can interactive. And another, I'm not going to go too much into that, it's just I put a sound detection. Another one just showing you how, it's still going, let me close the app down. Another thing I created for this is it's basically a game, and it's like a Simon said, it's like a color match. So you've got Sphero here. Hopefully you can see. I'm going to try and get them so you can see the screen because this is slightly slower than what's happening on the screen. The object is to get Sphero the same color as the outside color. So if I start the game up and the circle will decrease, so I've got to turn Sphero. And when he does, he vibrates and he says, you're ready. And you can see his score, the score going up as you're going through. So you've got it. And the faster you go, the further on you go, the faster the circles disintegrate. And I'm looking at the screen, so it's quite hard. And then when you finish, if you've got the highest score, there we are, and he jumps off. So basically, you can control it and integrate it with games. There's apps out there which you can download, people have created, but what I've done here is done it so everybody can create something very, very simple to control Sphero and to interact, because Sphero is a very, very powerful robot. You can use it for measuring rooms. I've got a lot of ideas installed for it I'm going to be doing. That app took me about an hour to do. Wasn't this the code blocks, there's not a lot to it.